it's a great question, because I think we're all starting to focus on the places that are hard to control, but maybe we spend a lot of time in elevators, bathrooms, and people are thinking a lot about public transportation. Look, I think the same general principles apply. And again, it's one of these things where everyone has a responsibility. So the government that's running the public transportation has a responsibility to put in these engineering controls, do what they can in terms of ventilation, filtration on the car, and administrative controls in terms of queuing. Companies and society have a responsibility to try and de-densify our routine. Once we reopen society and work, everyone shouldn't be rushing back at 9 a.m. on a Monday morning trying to hit these trains like we normally do. That's not going to work. So we have to extend the workday, go to A-B tests, A-B days, so we can de-densify the demand, both at the office building, but then in transit. Last, a lot of this is going to come down to personal responsibility. In fact, the only way through this is if we all take these precautions. That means mask wearing in public. That means being hyper-vigilant in places like in an elevator, where there are very little controls we can put in place, and in subway cars or on a bus. I like the idea of looking away from others. Wearing a mask will also help prevent the spread of large droplets. But these are the environments where we have to be especially respectful of each other, recognizing that any of us could be a carrier of this. We know there's asymptomatic transmission that can occur. And so you want to act as if you have it and might give it to somebody else. And if you take that mindset, yeah, I think the normal thing to do would be to turn your head away, wear your mask, cover your cough, make sure to wash your hands. And maybe most importantly, don't leave the house if you're not feeling well.